Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, we will see how to fix if your Windows 11 keeps freezing randomly. This problem can be irritating for most of the users. To fix this problem, we have different solutions for you. Let's start with solution number one. In this case, you have to simply right click on the start button and select settings. In the settings app, go to system, then display. Under scale and layout, make sure that display resolution is correctly set for your system. If you like, you can change the current screen resolution to a different setting to check if that resolves the problem. Also, you can change the scale setting for your display. So here we have also the option for changing the scaling factor. Once you change these two settings, check if the problem is resolved with that. In case if issue still persist, let's move to solution number 2. Right click on the start button and select run. In run window, type %TEMP% and press the enter key or click OK to execute this command. This will open the temporary files folder. Here the main motive is to remove the temporary files from your system. These temporary files are generated by various programs and you will be hardly able to know what these temporary files are doing because they are automatically generated. So removing these temporary files can resolve the problem for you. So simply clean up the temporary files folder. This is the second advice. Now let's see the third solution. In this case, you have to open the command prompt. Head over to the search icon on the taskbar and type cmd. From search results, select command prompt, then run as administrator. Click yes in the user account control confirmation prompt. In the command prompt window, simply type sfc /scan now and press the enter key. Now this command will check for the corrupted files on the system and repair them. Basically, it repairs the system core files for corruption. Let this process to be completed 100%, and once it is done, make sure you restart your system. In case if SFC reported some corrupted files but couldn't fix them, we have the next DISM command you can try in the same command prompt window. Simply paste this DISM command from the video description and press the enter key. Let the operation to be completed 100%, and once the DISM command, that is a restore health command, completes 100%, hopefully the problem should be resolved. Next we have solution number 4. Under solution number 4, I suggest you to run a full scan of your system. So if you are using Windows Security as your primary antivirus, simply open Windows Security, go to Virus and Threat Protection, and there you have the scan options. Select the full scan and click on Scan Now. Now let the scan be completed to 100%. In case if there are security threats found on your system, Windows Security will deal them and remove them, and this will help you to resolve the issue. In case if you are having third-party antivirus, you can perform a full scan using that as well. Up next, we have solution number 5. In this case, you have to simply right-click on the start button and select run. In run window, type sysdm.cpl and click OK. Now in the system properties window, switch to advanced tab. Then under performance, click settings. In the performance options, switch to advanced. Under virtual memory, click on change. There you have to uncheck automatically manage paging file size for all drives option. And there you have to select the custom size. Now you have to type the initial size in MB and maximum size in MB. So the initial size is usually 1.5 times of your RAM and maximum size is usually 3 times of the RAM. I can't guide you on the actual numbers here because your system may have different RAM installed and you have to do the calculation to type in the exact values here. So the custom paging file size is now available, which may also help you to resolve this issue. Then we have solution number 6. In this case, right click on the start button and select run. In run window, type mdsched.exe and press the enter key or click OK. Now a small window will open which says Windows Memory Diagnostic, and this is basically a small inbuilt program in Windows 11 operating system that helps you to check your memory problems and diagnose them. So you have to simply save your work, close all the apps, and you have to click on the restart now and check for problems. Then we have solution number 7. In this case, I suggest to update the display driver. Simply right click on the start button and select device manager. In the device manager window, expand display adapters, and there you will be able to locate your primary display driver or adapter. You have to simply right click on it and select update driver. Now follow the next prompt on screen. In case if you are not able to update driver using this method, you have to manually update your display driver, and for that you have to go to your device manufacturer's website and download the display driver for your system model from there. And lastly, we have solution number 8. In this case, right click on the start button and select settings. In the settings app, go to system, then recovery, and under recovery options we have a reset PC option. You have to click on reset PC, and under reset this PC window you have to choose an option. So make sure you carefully select here keep my files, because if you select remove everything, it will delete all of your data on the system. We are resetting by keeping our files, so you have to select carefully keep my files option here, and then you can select if you want to make local reinstall or cloud reinstall. So in this case I selected local reinstall and then click next, and in this way you have to simply reset the PC by keeping your data. And once you do that, your PC will reset, and additionally the Windows 11 freezing problem will go away permanently. In case if issue still persists, do let me know your comments. I'll be happy to help you. And that's it for now in this video. Thanks for watching it. If you found it helpful, do like it, share it, and don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel for more videos.